In a previous episode, I showed the incredible musical keyboard for the Commodore 64. And in that episode, I mentioned something about the SFX Sound Expander and how they were extremely rare. Well, not too long ago, I received this in the mail. It was donated to me by Robert Lazarus from the UK. So let's have a look at this thing. It obviously fits into the Commodore 64's cartridge port, and it gives you an additional cartridge port on top. I guess that way you could leave it in the system all the time if you wanted to. It will also fit into the Commodore 64C, as well as in the Commodore 128. Over here it has an audio output jack.
So now you got to keep in mind that the internal sound from your SID chip is still coming from the port in the back of the computer. So if you want to hear the sound from the sound expander, you'll have to plug in a separate audio cable.
However, I'm going to be connecting mine through the Zoom recorder so that you guys can get clear audio from it. Externally, you'll see it looks extremely similar to Commodore's Magic Voice cartridge, which was a speech synthesizer. It appears they used the same case design for both. Inside, you'll see that it contains a Yamaha YM3526 FM synthesizer chip. This chip is very similar. In fact, it is totally interchangeable with the YM3812 found in the Adlib and Sound Blaster cards for the IBM PC.
So, let's see what happens when I plug this bad boy into my Commodore 64.
When I power it on, absolutely nothing happens. That's because there's no ROM chip, no software at all inside the cartridge. It only contains the FM chip.
So, in order to use this thing, you're going to need some software that actually supports it. Now, I'm only familiar with one piece of software, and that's the software that came with it. Now, originally it was distributed on both floppy disk and cassette tape, but I have been unable to find either one of them.
But I did find the software online, so I can use my SD to IEC device to load the software onto an SD card and get it onto my C64 that way. It still takes a minute or two for the software to load. Well, here we are. Now we can use the keys on the keyboard to play some tunes. But there is a better way to do this. We can use the musical keyboard overlay. That works a lot better.
Okay, so I was very grateful to receive this gift. It's a pretty unusual piece of hardware, but believe it or not, just a couple weeks later, I received another one of these in the mail from Tom Carlson out of Virginia. And it gets even better because he sent me the external keyboard unit as well. I never actually thought I'd see one of these in person, much less own one myself, which I guess I do now. This keyboard is actually pretty big. It's a lot bigger than I thought it was looking at the photographs. It's got a full 61 keys, but they are full-size keys. And if you compare it, you'll see it's actually pretty big compared to some of these like toy keyboards up here.
It has a ribbon cable here that attaches to the side of the cartridge. And yes, you can use both keyboards at the same time if you wanted to. So now I think I can do a full test of the system. The software is essentially controlled by three keys. These two are used to navigate the menus, and then this one is used to select things. So first thing you might notice is that you can select different instruments. Some of the instruments here are pretty good. Alright, let's try the strings. And here's the electric piano. Of course, I'm not going to show every single one of these, but here's the flute. Let's play synth 1. And now synth 2.
Okay.
Interestingly enough, there is another sound bank you can load, which will give you another set of instruments. This is a weird sounding one, especially on the higher notes. Here are some more strings. Raindrop sounds neat. Here's you some more of that Harry Potter song. Cosmic wow. It does kind of sound like someone saying wow. Ah yes, I love the sweet flute. It has a sort of sustained reverb sound to it, which is really cool. Alien sounds like something out of a 1980s sci-fi show, maybe Doctor Who or something like that. You can do some other useful things, like transpose the keyboard by a few notes, or over here you can do it by a whole octave. You can also split the keyboard so that one side plays a different instrument from the other. And in this section here, the LH stands for left hand, so you can pick what instrument the left hand part is going to play. And over here you can select some different drum rhythms. So let's give this a shot and see if I can play my theme song here. Of course, if you don't like my demonstration, there are several demonstration songs on the disc that you can listen to.
Okay, so what do I think about this device? Well, the biggest downfall of the Sound Expander is simply lack of software. I mean, it's, I guess, kind of a chicken and egg scenario. I mean, I guess there was, the SID chip inside the Commodore 64 was good enough that I guess the other software manufacturers never really thought there was any point in putting products out that would support this. Now, as far as the software that comes with it, it doesn't actually compose or edit music in any way. It's simply for playing it live. So in essence, it doesn't have any more capability than if you were to just buy like a regular FM keyboard made during the same time period from Yamaha or something like that. It's going to sound pretty similar, and you don't have to have a big Commodore 64 and a monitor nearby in order to use it. So, I mean, it's not all that useful for just playing music. Now, I have heard, or at least read on some forums, the possibility that maybe there was some editing or composition software that SFX made, but I have not been able to find a copy of it if it exists. That would actually make this device a lot more functional if you could actually edit music with it. Having said all that, it's still a great piece of Commodore history, so very collectible, and I'm thrilled to have it. Alright, so again, I want to give a shout out to the two guys who donated these to me, and believe it or not, I've actually received several other donations in the past few weeks, several other keyboards, mostly Casio, although I did get a Roland MT32 donated to me as well, so you'll eventually be seeing that. So thank you guys for all the donations, and look forward to presenting those to you.